all are having a great day and welcome to the show. So today the topic is, by using star delta transformation, determine the equivalent resistance between P and Q. So this is a problem given, okay, and this is under the topic of star delta transformation. Okay, so in this topic, what he has asked, like, he asked to find out the resistance between P and Q. Okay, so in between P and Q, you should find one resistance. So this entire network, which is in complex form, should be transformed into, like, P and Q should have only one resistance. Some resistance R total we can take, and we should have only one resistance between P and Q. So we need to reduce all these resistances elements into one. Okay, for that we have series and parallel already. But look at this. See, this is like, if you can solve series and parallel, we will be solving in this way or this way also. Okay, and but here, like, if you have a complex network like this, see the construction how it is. So in this manner cannot be solved easily by series and parallel. In fact, you need to use star in a transformation to reduce the network first and then use series and parallel. Okay, so I'll tell you how. So like this, you see, if we have any star connections here which have nodes, okay, this has a node, okay, but this is not a star because there is an element of 3 ohms in between. So if we have only 4, 6, 10, then it is a star, but we have a 3 in between, so it is not a star. Do we have any stars here? No. Let us take delta. Delta is like a closed loop. So how many closed loop we have? We have 1, we have 2, we have 3. Okay, so to start solving here, it will be a bit difficult. Here also difficult. So let us start from the center. Okay, so this is a closed loop. So let us start from the center. So indirectly, we have got a delta. So given is a delta. Okay, in which format? See, I'll draw only that. We have 6 ohms, 3 ohms and 4 ohms. So this is a delta. Okay, this can be, because this is a closed loop, this can be transformed into a star. Okay, it can be transformed into a star. Okay, we have given delta, we have transformed a star. So how a star can be transformed? By keeping a node in between and connecting all these elements. This and this. So I have connected a star in between, and I'll give like R1, R2, R3. Okay, so I have given 3 element names R1, R2, R3, and I have formed a new star in between a delta. So now it is a delta to star connection, right? So delta is given and star we need to find. So the elements will be like R1 will be here, R2 here, R3 here, because these are the things we need to find. So R1. So R1 is in between which delta elements? 3 and 4. So this is a 3 into 4, product of 3 into 4 by add all the delta elements, because for delta the denominator will be same. So 3 plus 4 plus 6. So this is equal to 12 by 13, which is 0.92 ohms. Now look at R2. R2 obviously is in between 3 and 6. So product of 3 into 6 by 3 plus 4 plus all the delta elements. So this is 18 by 13. That is equal to 1.38 ohms. Okay. Now R3. R3 is in between which elements? 4 and 6. So 4 into 6 by add all the delta elements. 4 plus 3 plus 6. So that is 24 by 13. That is 1.846 ohms. Okay. So we got the star elements. So now delta is removed. Okay. Let me tell you here. Okay, I'll keep this aside for you. Let us draw the diagram again. See, this is 7 ohms, what I have drawn from 7 ohms. I have drawn a 7 ohms here. Okay, from here, okay, this is a delta element. So we have transformed the delta into a star. Okay, so this has been, sorry, this has been changed. The 10 will be as it is. Okay, I'll just leave it and I'll draw the remaining thing. So this 4 ohms from here, our 10 ohms is as it is same. The rest all are same. So this 14.46 and this is 8. Okay, we have 7 here, we have 20 here, and here we have Q, and here we have P. Okay, now we have transformed this into R1, R2, R3. Okay, so we have here R1, we have here R2, and we have here R3. So this R1, R2, R3. So problem will be, change a pen for your convenience, keep a node. Okay, so this is R1, this is R2 what we got, and this R3. See, the entire delta has been transformed into a star. Now what is R1 what we got from calculation? 0.92 ohms. R2 is 1.38 ohms, and R3 is 1.846 ohms. Okay, so this is the calculation what we got. Now take out this paper and let us see this thing. Okay, now see what happens. Really, if we can see, these two are in series, these two are in series, and these two are in series. Okay, we have got three series connections. So if we have series, just add it. So it is 4 plus 1.38, this becomes 5.38 ohms. Okay, 10 plus 1.86 is become 11.846 ohms, and 7.92 ohms. See, we got three series connections. So let us redraw the diagram. See how many times you redraw the diagram. Okay, that much clarification you will get it. So our resistances were decreased. So the 7.92, this 5.38 and this 11.846. So the rest are here. We have 14.46 as it is. We have 8 ohms here. Okay, we have 7 and we have 20. Okay, so this is what we got. Now see, do we have any other series connections here? Yes, we do have. We have a series here. 5.38 plus 14.46 will become 19.84 ohms. So our diagram will be still reduced. Okay, let me draw here itself. Okay, so P as it is, and this 7.92 is as it is. Okay, now this 11.846 ohms, this is 7, this is 20, this is 8, and obviously when these two are combined together, this becomes 19.84. see, the number of elements are getting decreased. Okay, now do we have any series parallel? Okay, we have a series here. 7 plus 20 is 27 ohms. Okay, now let us redraw the diagram again. Okay, I am dividing the page into two and I am redrawing here itself to avoid much confusion. See how many, in initial stage, if you are learning any network, please draw how many diagrams you get. You have to draw those many. Okay, see 27, I am taking an element down. So this 27, this is 8. If you draw as many diagrams when solving the problem, when you're getting your paper evaluated, it creates a good impression that you are trying and you are solving step by step. Okay, so that you're getting good marks also. Okay, now can we do any series parallel here? Do anything left here? Okay, I don't think there are any series parallel. So now what we shall do? Now, do we find any like star or delta connection? Okay, maybe we have a node here. So if we can bring this construction to here, so like 7.92, so 19.84, nothing, I have just drawn here itself for your clear understanding. Okay, this is 11.846 ohms, and these are as it is, like 27 ohms and 8 ohms, these are as it is. See, now do we have any star? Yes, we do have a star. Okay, this is the star what we get. See, 7.92, 19.84, and 11.846 ohms. So this is a star what we get. And now this star can be transformed into a delta, right? Because we'll see by transforming that to delta and for solving the equation. Okay, so draw a delta around it. Now, if you are like drawing a delta around it, what happens? Okay, so let me take a loop like this, which is RA. Okay, and this RB, and this RC. See, this is a delta which is formed around this star. Okay, now we got star elements and we need to find delta. So delta elements we have taken as RA, RB, RC. Okay. Now for delta, your numerator will be the same. When you find delta, your numerator will be the same. What is the numerator here? Okay, 7.92 into 19.84. You need to multiply one by one. 7.92 into 19.84 plus 19.84 into 11.846 plus, okay, 11.846 into 7.92, and that equals to 485.97. I already calculated. Okay, and what is RA? Okay, we are finding RA. RA is opposite to which star element? RA delta element is opposite to this star element, 11.846. So this is by 11.846, that is equal to 41.02 ohms. Okay, and now let us see RB. RB, obviously the numerator will be the same for all. So I'm writing the numerators here. I'm not doing it again. Okay, and RB is in which opposite star element? Is opposite to 7.92. So here the answer is 61.3 ohms. Okay, and RC is opposite to which star element? 19.84. See, this is star element, opposite ones we have to take. Okay, and this is equal to 24.49 ohms. So we now got RA, RB, RC. Okay, now we have to construct another diagram. Okay, so for constructing it, so now these star elements have been removed and formed into a delta. So let us draw P as it is. Okay, and now from P, okay, there is RA element. See, these two are removed. So RA. RA is what? 41.02 ohms. Okay, now I'll keep Q at the top. Okay. For more this thing, okay, and I'll keep this as it is. So this 27 ohms, this 8 ohms. So I've created these two as it is. In between, we have RC and RB, okay, from here to here and from here to here, okay. So this RB and this RC. So RB. RB is how much we got? 61.3, and this is RC. What we got is 24.4 microns. See, our elements are much reduced, and now we can see clearly. Okay, these two are in parallel, and these two are in parallel. Because there is current dividing here as well as here. So these two are parallel, these two are parallel. So what is a parallel thing? What we do is, so 27 R1 R2 by R1 plus R2 into 24.4 by R1 plus R2. So that comes at 12.81 ohms. And here is 61.3 R1 into R2 is 8 by R1 plus R2. So that comes to 7.07 ohms. See, it is much reduced. Now let us redraw the diagram again. How many times you have to draw that many times? Okay, so this as it is, your RA was left as it is. So I am writing 41.02 as it is and Q, and these two are reduced. So I'll draw like this. So this becomes like 12.81 and 7.07. I hope you are clearly seeing this. Okay, now these two are in series. So 12.81 plus 7.07. Okay, because there is no current division. Current is coming like this and is leaving, or current coming like this or is leaving. Okay, there is no current division in between. So these two are in series. So obviously this is 19.88 ohms. So our diagram is much reduced. Okay, let us draw again the diagram here. I'm dividing the page here. So P, okay. From P we have 41.02 as it is, it is not changed, and this come to 19.98. So I am drawing like this. Now let tell me this series or parallel. This is obviously parallel because current is getting divided here. If it's coming from P, it is divided into two parts. Coming from Q, divided into two parts. So this here, these are in parallel. Okay, so parallel connection is what, like R1 R2 by R1 plus R2. You can take anything as R1, anything as R2. So 41.02 into 19.88 by 41.02 plus 19.88. The answer is 13.39. So our last one is P and Q. This is 13.39 ohms. See, the equivalent PQ. So this is a diagram, right, what we get. This is the question what we asked. He asked P and Q, the equivalent resistance between P and Q. So we should have only one resistance between P and Q, and that we got here. So this is RT. So your resistance between P and Q, or you can write like RPQ, is equal to 13.39 ohms. So this is how you can solve a complex problem by using star delta and delta to star, and of course series parallel will be there. Okay, this is useful for network analysis people and for BEEE subject people also, because star delta is really an important topic. Okay, hope you got it. See you soon. Asha Mahi signing off. Bye.